You don't see this bike much. As when I use this bike, as often as not, it's jumping on it to do errands. It's probably a pretty boring thing to video. There are a couple of specific videos about this bike. One of my most viewed videos is from, would it be 3 years ago? 3.5 years ago, when I first got the bike. Took it for its first spin, when it was bog standard. Since then, of course, it's been completely reworked, and there have been a couple of videos which have kept you apprised of that. Still some to do. I'm going to fit the square taper cranks from an 83 Superb, and I have one of the modern shifters to go on it. That's coming off my Gazelle Populaire, because that's been converted to a Shimano 8-speed. Yeah. So a little bit about the channel. Get over the obsession with the new Brooks saddle and talk about channel things. It's been a bit erratic of late. There's been a couple of slight gaps of best part of a week or whatever, and then a flurry of videos and a gap and a flurry. That's just how it goes. That's just life, I'm afraid. And I do have occasional internet problems. And I do regularly get constructive criticism, and it's the same comments, and it is a constructive criticism, and I do appreciate it, and I do note it as well. Pretty good. I don't get haters in my comments. I get there's one person, as soon as a video goes up, a thumbs down will go onto it. I feel that person must have gone to the trouble of setting alerts just so they can come and put a thumbs down on a video. Strange mindset to put that much energy into making sure that I know that they hate me, but I don't know who they are. However, I appreciate it, whoever you are, because as far as YouTube's algorithms are concerned, it's interaction and it's a view. So thank you very much. Now to the various regulars who have issued the same criticism. There are two things I would like to improve with the videos more urgently than anything else. That is, you hear it? The wind noise. I'll turn around so that you're not getting the wind noise. Yeah, the wind noise is a persistent problem, as is this business. I would like the camera work to be smoother, and I would like to eliminate the wind noise. Both have been criticisms, both are extremely valid criticisms, and they are my own criticisms of myself as well. Two items will solve that. For the camera shake, I need a gimbal. For the sound, I need a proper mic, an external mic. The little fluffy mouse on the lapel will do nicely. And go around here. Both of those cost money. And they don't cost a great deal of money, but I have rather less than even a small deal of money these days. For the last few years, I've been rather skint. Buying of bicycles every now and again, and buying of bicycle parts and accessories, really just comes from whenever I've sold one. I sell bikes to fund this, and I sell bikes to pay the bills sometimes as well. And yeah, we've had we've had difficult financial times the last couple of years. Nobody's fault, not blaming anybody, it's just how it is. Lots of people are in the same boat this year after the coronavirus. But it does make me wonder whether I should really be carrying this on. And it certainly puts a pause on buying equipment for the channel. I just can't justify it at the moment. I'm currently using an iPhone 8 Plus, is it? Well, it's the big one anyway. Which is, what, 3-4 years old now. It's fine. It does the job. I use a free editing program on the phone. My cameras have both really been outdated now by the phone. The phone camera has overtaken them, so I just use the phone all the time. I have editing on the laptop, but really for what I do, Video Leap on the phone is fine. I'm aware that this phone is getting old, it needs a new battery soon. So I'm going to have to put the money aside for a battery for the phone. Then I will try and get an external mic and a gimbal. The mic for an iPhone with a lightning connection, see, it's not a jack. You can get an adapter into an iPhone lightning connector to a jack, but the iPhone rejects it. I've tried two different ones and it just says this accessory not supported and kicks it out. So it's going to have to be one for the job, I'm afraid. Now, you don't see adverts on this channel because I haven't monetized this channel, and that's been a deliberate choice because I didn't see myself as a professional YouTuber. It's not why I went into this. These videos are just for people's enjoyment and people's information and my own pleasure in doing them as well. And I've never felt like it was justified monetizing. Added to that, I've not had the subscribers. YouTube have a program for creators whereby you go through various tutorials online. I've done all that, so I'm there waiting to be a creator. I have the necessary amount of viewing minutes per annum on my channel. That's not a problem. I promised myself I would look at it again when I got to 1,000 subscribers. The 1,000 subscribers is coming up fast, and 900 and something now. It's approaching quickly. So I'm wondering whether I should sign up for Patreon. I've looked at Patreon. It's easy enough for me to do. I qualify for it, so I'm wondering about that. What I never want to do is to be one of these YouTubers that holds things back just for their Patreon supporters. If I go the Patreon route, it will be purely a voluntary support for the channel. I'm not going to be doing the hard sell, and I'm not going to be holding back content just for Patreons and excluding everything else. It's against my ethics, both as a person and as a lapsed Quaker, to make anything exclusive. That's an abhorrent word to me. So whatever I do regarding Patreon, my regular viewers will be able to see everything. I can probably come up with goodies for Patreons, maybe t-shirts or something like that, but they will also be available to everybody else. But Patreons might get a freebie or something. I'll look at that, but I'm never going to hold content back for Patreons only. So, as we hit 1,000 subscribers, I'll let you know what I've decided to do. And I think if I can get a few people keen enough to put a few quid into the pot, it'll help me equip the channel properly and make better quality videos without wind noise and without too much of this business. And being skint myself, I will never criticize anyone for not giving. There are channels I'd like to give to and I can't, so there will be no stigma attached to not giving on Patreon. It will be purely and utterly voluntary. And now my battery is running out, so thank you very much for watching. I'm going to tilt this saddle back a notch and then pop down the shops. Meanwhile, I've got five dogs waiting to be walked.